Price Hill, a community which is still community enough to have its own Thanksgiving parade.
Happy Thanksgiving!
But Price Hill is full of big problems too: poverty, deteriorating housing, and a deteriorating sense of well-being.
There was a couple guys over there getting ready to fight, and they boxed for a minute, and then the one guy pulled a gun.
If Price Hill were to have its own soundtrack other than What's in a Parade, it would probably include rock, hip-hop, country, and a bit of salsa. It would definitely not include But four musicians are trying to change Price Hill's image.
My name is Scott Jackson, and I play violin.
My name is Rachel Frankenfeld, and I play violin.
My name is Laura Jekyll, and I play the cello.
My name is Stephen Goist, and I play the viola.
These 20-something musicians are the Price Hill String Quartet. No joke. Not the Indian Hill String Quartet, nor the Hyde Park String Quartet, but blue-collar or even low-income Price Hill, a place not on the map of other classical musicians.
They're usually like, that's a trip. I'm serious. I mean, I was just talking to a Cincinnati symphony musician about this, and she was kind of baffled, but I mean, really admired the concept.
We're trying to change also that perception of Price Hill as a place where you wouldn't want to go, to Price Hill as a place where there's art, there's great youth programming, there's great restaurants. It's really an exciting place.
29-year-old cellist Laura Jekyll founded the quartet last year as an outgrowth of a program she runs called My Cincinnati. Free after-school classical music lessons to Price Hill neighborhood children who otherwise could not afford them and who otherwise might never know what classical music is.
One thing we're trying to do is make it so eventually, long-term goal, so that classical music or just music with these kinds of instruments doesn't feel foreign to this neighborhood or really to any neighborhood in Cincinnati.
As for the quartet, Laura and three other musicians started by playing one neighborhood concert, calling themselves the Price Hill String Quartet. But they kept playing and the name stuck.
5, 6.
27-year-old Scott Jackson is a student at UC's College Conservatory of Music.
And what beat was that?
5.
A native of Las Vegas, Scott grew up surrounded by music. Price Hill, a big difference.
One of our primary missions is to sort of let people of Price Hill who typically might not have this experience or might not be able to afford going to the symphony or might not even, you know, be interested in it, and letting them sort of have a new experience where they're comfortable and don't feel any pressure to like kind of conform to typical classical etiquette. Can I hear more of Rachel?
Sure, yeah.
I'd love to hear it. I think your line's like really kind of sensuous.
Yeah.
27-year-old Rachel Frankenfeld from Bellingham, Washington plays professionally with the Dayton Symphony. To Rachel, playing before a different type of audience, a Price Hill audience, has more purpose.
It has a much deeper meaning to me because it's different than just seeing the same people that I see at, you know, symphony concerts or other chamber music concerts. It just seems like it's a much more diverse audience. It's really neat.
22-year-old Stephen Goist is the only native Cincinnatian, Clifton Heights and College Hill.
So growing up, I had a lot of friends who lived in Price Hill, and they didn't have the best view of it. It wasn't very enjoyable to live in. They didn't feel safe all the time.
But now, through music, this CCM student is getting a more positive view.
I like the idea of sort of changing the face of classical music as part of a community, and less about, you know, dressing up in your tuxedo and ball gown and going downtown to music hall for a concert.
Which brings us back to Laura Jekyll, the founder. She knows classical music will never top the charts in Price Hill, but at least it's starting to move the needle. A native of Boston, Laura is the only member of the quartet to actually live in Price Hill.
I have really, really grown to love the neighborhood.
The quartet practices at Laura's house, and she may be winning over Price Hill one person or two at a time.
I could hear the two neighbors across the street talking to each other about the music, and actually they were very positive. They were saying that they were going to move their lawn chair over and so they could hear a little bit better, or that we should open our windows.
And the group is taking their story on the road, playing concerts not just in Price Hill, but for example, in upper middle class Montgomery, where people may chuckle about the idea of a Price Hill string quartet until they hear it.
We're still fulfilling our mission because of our name, because we're representing Price Hill, and people out in Montgomery, maybe there will be people at this concert who have never been to Price Hill, who might kind of start thinking of the neighborhood in a different way because they know that the Price Hill String Quartet exists.
If this was the Indian Hill String Quartet, they'd still be good. But because they're the Price Hill String Quartet, they have power. The power to move a community's image from the outside and from the inside. Price Hill's image of itself.
I don't think anything really exists like the Price Hill String Quartet.
Jeff Hirsch, Local 12 News.